We've been waiting for this news all day, and we have it courtesy of Louis van Gaal, whose statement has been issued just now on the Manchester United website. This is what van Gaal has had to say this evening. It has been an honour to manage such a magnificent club as Manchester United, and in doing so, I have fulfilled a long-held ambition. I'm immensely proud to have helped United win the FA Cup for a 12th time in the club's history. I've been privileged during my management career to have won 20 trophies, but winning the FA Cup, which is steeped in so much history, will always be one of the most special achievements of my career.
He goes on to say, I'm very disappointed to be unable to complete our intended three-year plan. I believe that the foundations are firmly in place to enable the club to move forward and achieve even greater success. I hope that winning the FA Cup will give the club a platform to build upon next season to restore the success that its passionate set of fans desire.
Yeah, he goes on to reflect as well, saying, having managed in Holland, Spain and Germany, I had always hoped for the opportunity to manage in English football and be part of English culture. Both of these experiences have lived up to expectations and been fantastic. I thank my players, he says, and wish them well for next season. It has been a pleasure to work with them, and it has been particularly rewarding to see so many young players take their chance to break into the first team and excel. He's given a couple of their opportunity this season, hasn't he? And he says, I look forward to watching the continued development of these young players next season. Then goes on to thank a few people.
Yeah, thank you to the owners and board of Manchester United for giving me the opportunity to manage this great club. I would also like to express my gratitude to the amazing United supporters. They are truly the best fans in the world.
A confirmation then from Manchester United on their Twitter account. They say, we are delighted to announce that Jose Mourinho is our new manager. It's accompanied as well by a statement on their website that says Jose Mourinho will take over as manager of Manchester United from the 2016-17 season. He signed a three-year contract with an option to remain at the club until at least 2020. The 53-year-old Jose has managed at the top level of European football, it says, for over a decade. In that time, he's won league titles and cups in four countries, Portugal, England, Italy and Spain, as well as winning the Champions League twice with Porto and Inter Milan. Some reaction from Ed Woodward, yep, who, announcing the appointment, has said this.
Jose is quite simply the best manager in the game today. He has won trophies and inspired players in countries across Europe. And, of course, he knows the Premier League very well, having won three titles here. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome him to Manchester United. His track record of success is ideal to take the club forward. Jose Mourinho has said this. To become Manchester United manager is a special honour in the game. It is a club known and admired throughout the world. There is a mystique and a romance about it which no other club can match. I've always felt an affinity with Old Trafford. It has hosted some important memories for me in my career, and I've always enjoyed a rapport with the United fans. I'm looking forward to being their manager and enjoying their magnificent support in the coming years.
Yeah. Really starting to hot up, aren't they? Things reaching us all the time. Got some news as well concerning Manchester United, and that we are hearing that Eric Bailly has passed his medical to go to Manchester United. He's a Villarreal defender, 22 years old, currently playing for the Ivory Coast. But this is a news reaching us just this minute that Eric Bailly has passed his medical for Manchester United. We shall keep you up to date on all the transfer news over the summer.
Starring as Armenia's all-time top scorer with 19 goals in 59 caps since his international debut in January of 2007. He captains his national team and has received the Armenian Footballer of the Year award on five occasions.
It's Zlatan time.
Salute to Nexus Nation, it's your boy T Nexus, and welcome to a brand new series on the channel. This is Jose's journey. I will be trying to get Manchester United back where they belong, which is at the top of the Premier League in the first season. Because ever since Fergie retired, Manchester United have never won a Premier League title. But now Jose's in charge, things will be different. Also, just to let you guys know, the squads are customised, so As you saw in the intro, Manchester United have signed Eric Bailly, Henrik Mkhitaryan and Zlatan Ibrahimovic. So, I've added them to the squad. We skipped pre-season and I will be having a huge clear out, selling players I don't want and buying players I think we need. So everyone that being said, let's get started. Alright, Nexus Nation, welcome to our capital where we'll be playing the first game of the season against Tottenham Hotspur. Let's hope Jose Mourinho can get his first 3 points in charge of Manchester United. There was a goal! Memphis Depay! 1-0 Manchester United! Let's go! Let's go! This is the last one you remember it. The good ball. Morgan Schneiderlin! Oh, lucky. And that's half time. Manchester United lead by a goal to nil thanks to Memphis Depay. Desi, we have on the bench, you got Anthony Martial, Bastian Schweinsteiger, Herrera, Ashley Young, Valencia, Jones and Romero. We're not going to bring anyone on yet, so let's get into the second half. No! Off the post! Let's take off the pie and bring on Martial. Let's take off Carrick and bring on Schweinsteiger, bring off Snelling and put on Herrera. That's it, full time. Manchester United have come up 1-0 winners thanks to a goal from Memphis Depay. And honestly, I'm not surprised we had less possession because we kept giving the ball away so much. But that's the end of the first game and I'll see you all in the second one. Welcome to the second game of the episode. Well, Manchester United are facing off Hull City, and when I saw this on the calendar, I just remembered that I also put the teams that got promoted in this league too. So I put Hull City, Middlesbrough and Burnley, for Norwich, Aston Villa and Newcastle. And so Hull City replaced, I was supposed to play in Aston Villa, but because I swapped them around, Hull City replaced them. As you can see, the players watched as Nikita Jelovic, 2 goals in previous matches. In the last game against Tottenham, we managed to win 1-0, just Mourinho's first game. So in our first away game of the season, let's hope we can get 3 points here as well. Look at how he puts the ball in. Snap, we're going to get to it. He's falling again. Outside the box. Michael Carrick! Oh! Ooh, not too far away. Hey, yes. Time. Well, there we have it, half time, 0-0. David De Gea pulling out some tremendous saves to keep Manchester United in it. 7 touch, 3 on target. And those 3 on target have all been set by David De Gea. Gets it. Rooney. Ibra. Carrick. Michael Carrick! Oh! Sally. Find Ibra. Ibrahimovic! His first goal of the match puts Manchester United in front. Come on! Ibra. Finds the pie. Remember the pie twisting and turning. It's Carrick! Oh! Ibra. Wayne Rooney for 2-0, it is! Wayne Rooney! A brilliant dance by Zlatan Ibrahimovic! And he goes over to celebrate! To skip a foot, Manchester United 2-0 up! And that's surely game over now! Good ball, Carrick. To Zlatan! 3-0! Game over! As I said before, Zlatan with the heart celebration, go straight to the camera. Game, set, and match. And there you have it, guys. Manchester United 3, Hull City 0. 2 goals from Zlatan Ibrahimovic and a goal from the skipper Wayne Rooney. I'll see you guys in the final game of the episode. This is the final game of the episode, Nexus Nation. Well, we're faced off against another newly promoted side, Burnley, who have replaced Newcastle. We're back at Old Trafford. We've won 2 games out of 3 so far. Can we win 3 out of 3? Let's go, boys, it's that time. Ibra strikes! That time ref has a free kick. But this is Memphis Depay territory. There is Memphis Depay! Oh, I just over the bar. Damian. Mateo Darmian! That's through. Okay, that is 9 at half time. We are not going to make any subs, and I'll see you all in the second half. Look up, boys! Ibra! Makes it 1-0. Manchester United in front. Ibra with his first goal at Old Trafford. In the 62nd minute. And Rooney has a go, and it's straight at Heaton. Now it's time to make some subs. The regular ones bring off the pie for Martial, as well as Dagger. Zlatan Ibrahimovic on the run again. Ref goes down! I saw that red card! That's definitely a red card, last man back. It is. See you later. Michael Keane, former Manchester United player. The brother won't be too impressed. It's Rooney off the post. Look up for Anthony Martial! Mkhitaryan! Oh. No, that wasn't Mkhitaryan, was it? I have no idea who it was. Number 36. Oh. There we have it. 3 wins out of 3. Zlatan Ibrahimovic with the goal. Michael Keane with the red card. And 4-time wins of Manchester United 1. Burnley City 0. Alright, next is Nation. This is the end of the episode. We played 3 games against Tottenham, 1-1-0, Hull, 1-3-0, and Burnley, 1-1-0. If you enjoyed the episode, make sure to hit that like button, share, comment, and subscribe to the Nexus Nation. Also, subscribe to the fellow Nexus Nation members down below. And I want to give a quick shout out to someone who actually inspired me to make this series. His name is Hopnob777, so his link will be in the description down below as well. But that's all for now, Nexus Nation. I'll be back with this modern series soon. That's pretty much it. So this is your boy T-Nexus, signing out. Peace.